أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة حتى تركها على المحجة البيضاء، ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن خير الكلام كلام الله تبارك وتعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Verily, all praise is due to Allah. We praise Him and we seek His aid. We ask refuge in Allah from the evils of ourselves and the evils of our actions. Humsur Allah guide, man can lead astray. And humsur unta astrayna can guide. I bear witness that there is none worthy of worship except Allah alone with no partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is His slave and messenger. O you who believe in Allah, fear Allah in the way who should be feared, and die not except in the state of Islam, with full and complete submission to Allah. O you mankind, be dutiful to your Lord, who created you from a single person, that is Adam alayhi salam. And from him he created his wife, and from both of them he created many men and many women. Be dutiful to your Lord, from whom you demand your mutual rights. Keep tight relationship with your relatives, especially the kinship. Verily Allah is ever watcher upon you. O you who believe in Allah, fear Allah and say the truth. He will rectify your deeds and He will forgive your sins. And whomsoever obeys Allah and His Messenger will achieve a great achievement. The best of the speech is the speech of Allah Azza wa Jal, and the best of guidance is the guidance of our beloved Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the worst of actions are the newly invented matters in Islam. Well, every newly invented matter in Islam is innovation in Islam. And every innovation in Islam is misguidance. And every misguidance will lead to the hellfire. To proceed. My brothers and sisters in Islam, as we all know, today we're going to implement the sunnah of checking about the month of Ramadan. That's why the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Abdullah ibn Umar radiyallahu anhu, that he said that people, they went to check about the time of Ramadan or the beginning of Ramadan. And he said radiyallahu anhu, and I witnessed the month of Ramadan. And I came and I conveyed this to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then he commanded the people alayhi salatu wa salam. He commanded the people to fast the month of Ramadan. We need to understand, my brothers and sisters in Islam, it is a great month, the month, the season of the reward from Allah Azza wa Jal, where Allah Azza wa Jal is stated in the Quran. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان. The month of Ramadan is the month where Allah Azza wa Jal has revealed the Quran as a guide for the people, and as well وبينات من الهدى والفرقان, like clear evidences from the guidance from Allah تبارك وتعالى. فَمَنْ شَهِدَ مِنْكُمُ الشَّهَرَ فَلْيَصُمْ. Whoever witnessed the month, then they have to fast it. وَمَنْ كَانَ مَرِيضًا أَوْ عَلَى سَفَرٍ فَعِدَّةٌ مِنْ أَيَّامٍ أُخَرٍ. And whoever amongst you were ill or was traveler, then they can fast some other days. يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِكُمُ الْيُسْرَ وَلَا يُرِيدُ بِكُمُ الْعُسْرَ. Allah Azza wa Jalla wants ease for you, and Allah Azza wa Jalla doesn't want hardship for you. And Allah continued, وَلِتُكْمِنُ الْعِدَّةِ وَلِتُكَبِّرُ اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. So you complete the prescribed period, and you glorify Allah Azza wa Jal, and be thankful to Him, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. So my brothers and sisters in Islam, we need to understand that the month of Ramadan is a month of ibadah, an act of worship. You will find people who try to misinterpret the meaning of fasting. And then they will say, we fast in order for us to have a good health. Or some of them, they said, we fast in order to feel about the poor and the needy ones, how they suffer, etc. This is not the purpose of fasting, my brothers and sisters in Islam. The purpose of fasting the month of Ramadan is to obey Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Because Allah Azza wa Jal commanded us to fast. And if He did not do it, we will not do it. But Allah Azza wa Jal commanded us to fast the month of Ramadan. And that's why we are doing it out of obedience to Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And this is the purpose of fasting. Yes, there are some other wisdoms that comes along with fasting the month of Ramadan. But those are not the purpose behind fasting the month of Ramadan. Where Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned this clearly in the Quran. As the month, فَمَنْ شَهِدَ مِنْكُمْ الشَّهْرَ فَلْيَصُمْ. Whoever witnessed the month, then let them fast. This is what Allah Azza wa Jal commanded us. And that's why we fast the month of Ramadan. And the purpose of fasting is to obey Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And this is the purpose of fasting. And that's why Allah Azza wa Jal described the fasting in a way that it is unique. So we fast from the sunrise and from the dawn until the sunset. This is what Allah Azza wa Jal commanded us to do it. And we abstain, as Allah Azza wa Jal told us in the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, we abstain from eating and drinking and sexual intimacy during the day of the fasting, the month of Ramadan. And we do it for the sake of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. So that's why, if someone even didn't have the feeling about, for example, and we even though we are obliged to take care of the people, the needy ones, and the poor ones, but even though if someone didn't have the feeling during that day, it doesn't mean his fasting is not valid. As long as the person obey Allah Azza wa Jal and His Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam in terms of fasting the month of Ramadan. And that's why, my brothers and sisters in Islam, the month of Ramadan is the month of Rahmah, the month of Barakah, the month of mercy from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, the month of blessing from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. In the month of Ramadan, that the sins will be wiped. In the month of Ramadan, Allah Azza wa Jal will multiply our deeds, our righteous deeds, to be many, many times. And as well, it is a month where Allah Azza wa Jal will free people from the punishment of the hellfire. And as the hadith of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he stated, إِذَا دَخَلَ رَمَضَانَ فُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُ الْجَنَّةِ وَغُلِّقَتْ أَبْوَابُ جَهَنَّمِ وَسُلْسِلَةِ الشَّيَاطِينَ. In the beginning of Ramadan, when Ramadan starts, then the gates of Jannah will open, and the gates of the hellfire will be shut, and the devils will be locked in chains during this month. And that's why our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he stated in a hadith, مَنْ صَامَ رَمَضَانَ إِيمَانًا وَاحْتِسَابًا وَغُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ. Whoever fasted the month of Ramadan out of faith in Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, and as well wanted the pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jal in the day of judgment, then all his previous deeds will be wiped. All his previous evil deeds will be wiped. Whatever he has committed in the past, Allah Azza wa Jal will clean it for him. So it will expiate all his sins, as the hadith of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم continued, من قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Whoever did قيام الليل in the month of Ramadan out of faith in Allah تبارك وتعالى and wanted to gain the pleasure of Allah تبارك وتعالى, then Allah will expiate all his previous sins. So that's why, my brothers and sisters, it is the time that we need to understand the month of Ramadan, to prepare ourselves for the month of Ramadan. It could be tomorrow or the day after. Nevertheless, that we need to prepare for the month of Ramadan. And we need to welcome the month of Ramadan with open hearts. We're welcoming the month of Ramadan that we wanted to gain the pleasure of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And that's why, my brothers and sisters in Islam, in every single night in the month of Ramadan, Allah Azza wa Jal will free people from the punishment of the hellfire, starting from the first night. Starting from the very first night, as the hadith of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, in every single day and night, in the month of Ramadan, Allah will free people from the punishment of the hellfire. And as well for every Muslim, there is a dua. Allah will accept it. Allah will accept it. So it may be during this month of Ramadan. So that's why, my brothers and sisters, we need to take advantage of this month by preparing for the month of Ramadan, by first of all to repent to Allah Azza wa Jal from all the sins that we commit. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jal forgiveness. And repentance has conditions, my brothers and sisters in Islam, to stop the evil deed, to plan not to do it again, and to seek forgiveness from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, and add what we can do extra, which is to follow the evil deeds with righteous deeds, then Allah will replace it with righteous deeds for us. And as well, to abstain from all the things that the shortcoming that we have, our bad habits, and take this month of Ramadan as a month, as a turning point for us in our life. If you have bad habits, then start this month by stopping these bad habits. If you smoke cigarettes, quit smoking cigarettes. If you have bad habits, that you do it all the time, then take advantage of this month that to change these bad habits and to repent to Allah from it. And as we'll try to replace these bad habits with good habits, this is make this month of Ramadan as a month of turning point in your life. Because you never know, it might be the last Ramadan in your life. So that's why, take advantage of every single moment in this month of Ramadan to gain the pleasure of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And as well for those ones who backbite, for those ones who spread lies, for those ones who spread rumors, leave this habit for the sake of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And try to be a mu'min, a believer in Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Someone who followed the guidance of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to do what the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam commanded you. إِنَّمُ الْحُسْنِ إِيمَانِ الْمَرْءِ تَرْكُهُ مَا لَا يَعْنِيهِ. From the righteousness of the faith of the person, to leave something that is not related to you. Then it will ease your life, my brothers and sisters. And as well, it will reduce your sins. In that case, you will not backbite no one. You will not talk about anyone. You will not spread rumors about anyone. And this is what you should do as a believer in Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Start the month of Ramadan by as well to have a will and to be sincere to Allah Azza wa Jal in this will, that you wanted to take advantage of this month of Ramadan to gain the maximum reward from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. To do Qiyam al-Layl in every single night in the month of Ramadan. And as well to try to give for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal as a sadaqah to the best of your ability. And as well to try to recite the Quran and to finish the Quran in this great month, the month of Ramadan. And as well, the month of Ramadan is a month of dhikr and seeking forgiveness from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Take advantage as well during this month. When you go to your work in the morning, keep remembering Allah Azza wa Jal. When you come back from the work, remember Allah Azza wa Jal. When you have free time, remember Allah Azza wa Jal. Seek forgiveness. And as well, the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal, they are various. So that's why you could do many types of dhikr. And the best of the dhikr, as the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كلمتان خفيفتان على اللسان حبيبتان إلى الرحمن ثقيلتان في الميزان سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك سبحان الله العظيم. This is those are two sentences that are light on the tongue and they are dear to Allah تبارك وتعالى and they are heavy in the scale. سبحان الله وبحمدك سبحان الله العظيم. Seeking forgiveness from Allah تبارك وتعالى. So to seek forgiveness from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, as hadith, as the saying of Nuh alayhi salam, قلت استغفروا ربكم إنه كان غفارا يرسل السماء عليكم مدرارا ويمددكم بأموال وبنين ويجعل لكم جنات ويجعل لكم أنهارا ما لكم لا ترجون إلى الله وقارا. So Allah Azza wa Jal is saying on the tongue of Nuh alayhi salam, seek forgiveness from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. He is the one who forgives the sins. Then Allah will send the heaven raining to you. The sky will rain to you. And as well, Allah will prepare for you paradises under which the river flows. This is by the pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jal. to seek forgiveness from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Take advantage in the month of Ramadan that you try to do istighfar. Even our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah azza wa jal has expiated all his sins alayhi salatu wa salam. And he is infallible sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And yet, in one gathering, he used to seek forgiveness from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala over than 70 times sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we have, subhanallah, and we are more in need to seek forgiveness from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. So that's why, my brothers and sisters, try to do dhikr. And as we'll do something, what we call it, the family ibadah, an act of worship with the family. So that's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there is no a man, wakes up his wife, and they pray two rak'ah for the sake of Allah azza wa jal, except Allah will write them amongst those, al-dhakirin allaha kathiran wa al-dhakirat, those who remember Allah azza wa jal a lot from the men and the women. Take advantage of this month to practice this sunnah, to pray together with yourself and your family together, as will educate your children about the prayer, educate your children to pray Qiyam al-Layl. And as will the month of Ramadan, my brothers and sisters, is the month of Quran. And be amongst those who the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stated, خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَهُ. The best one amongst you are those ones who taught the Quran and those ones who learned the Quran. Be amongst them. If you are not teaching the Quran, then learn the Quran. Take advantage of this month of Ramadan. Try to rectify your recitation of the Quran. And as will teach your children even the small surahs for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. And do this as charity, as the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Whoever taught one single ayah from the Quran, he will have the reward of it. And the same reward of the people who are reciting it as long as it's being recited through that chain. So you could imagine if you taught your son just only Fatiha, and then your son will teach it to his children and the children of the children. So it will be this, the reward will be coming to you until the day of judgment. So that's why, my brothers and sisters, take advantage of this month. Gain the maximum reward from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And as well, do not abandon the important things, which is the obligations. We found some brothers, they do Qiyam al-Layl, and then until late in the night, and then they don't wake up for Fajr, subhanallah. So that's why, my brothers and sisters, we need to remember the most important things, especially in the month of Ramadan, is to practice the obligations of Islam. And the obligations of Islam are more dear to Allah Azza wa Jalla, more beloved to Allah Azza wa Jalla than all volunteer. To pray Fajr in Jama'ah, just only attending Takbirat al-Ihram with the Imam, it is more dear and beloved to Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala than doing Qiyam al-Layl all your life. You could imagine just only one single Takbir of Ihram, the beginning of the Salah. It is more dear and beloved to Allah Azza wa Jalla than doing Qiyam al-Layl, the voluntary one, throughout your life. Why? Because the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the hadith al-Qudsi, مَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدٌ بِعَمَلٍ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّا افْتَرَضْتُ عَلَيْهِ. That my servant will come close to me. The most dear deed to me are those ones who I made it obligation upon them. So those are more dear to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala than all your voluntary deeds. So that's why take advantage of this month. Try to fulfill your obligations, especially the salah, the 5 daily prayer. Try to pray them and to pray them with khushu', with the humility and humbleness to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, with full focus in the salah, and learn how to do it properly according to the Quran and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum fa yafawjal mustaghfirin astaghfirullah. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام الأتمان الأكملان على محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه وموالاه. My brothers and sisters in Islam, since fasting is an act of ibadah, then every act of ibadah has two main conditions. Firstly, sincerity to Allah تبارك وتعالى, and secondly, following the path of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. So that's why. That's why, my brothers and sisters, we need, when we are wanted to intend to fast the month of Ramadan, we should have the intention for in every single night in the month of Ramadan. And the intention is not a verbal thing, which means you don't need to say, I intend to fast this day or I intend to fast that day. It is in your heart, as long as you know in your heart that the next day is a day of fasting. It's not a day that you will be, you will have to break your fast. It's not a day that you'll be traveling. It's not that day. So as long as from the night that you know yourself the next day is a day of fasting, then this is intention. So that's why the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said alayhi salatu wa sallam, la siyama liman lam yubayyit as-siyama min al-layl. There is no valid fasting for those ones who didn't have the intention to fast the following day. And as well, the fasting as well, not just only to abstain from eating and drinking and sexual intimacy. It is as well to abstain from saying the falsehood and saying the things which is not allowed in Islam and doing the things which is not allowed in Islam. As the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, مَنْ لَمْ يَدَعَ قَوْلَ الزُّورِ, who didn't leave the speech of the falsehood, وَالْعَمَلُ بِهِ, and acting upon falsehood, وَالْجَهَلْ, and ignorance, فَلَيْسَ لِلَّهِ حَاجَةٌ فِي أَنْ يَدَعَ طَعَامُ وَشَرَابٌ. Allah has nothing to do with you leaving your food and drink. So it's not about to leave the food and drink. It's about to leave the sins for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. And as with the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, رُبَّ صَيَامٍ حَظُّهُ مِنْ صِيَامِهُ الْجُوعُ وَالْعَطَسِ. He said alayhi salatu wasalam, someone who's fasting, all what he gained from his fasting is being hungry and being thirsty. So don't be amongst those, my brothers and sisters in Islam. Be amongst those who wanted to gain the pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jal. As the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّ فِي الْجَنَّةِ بَابًا يُقَالُ لَهُ الرَّيَّانِ. There is a gate in Jannah. It is named الرَّيَّان. He said alayhi salatu wasalam, يَدْخُلُ مِنْهُ الصَّائِمُونَ. Those who are fasting, they will enter through the gate of الرَّيَّان in the day of judgment. And after they enter, then that gate will shut and no one will enter after them. The gate of الرَّيَّان, the gate of the people who are fasting. So be amongst those. And as well, see, as the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he said alayhi salatu wa sallam, all the righteous deeds of the son of Adam belongs to him, meaning that it is up to him whatever he wanted to do, and there is a prescribed reward for it, except fasting. It is up to Allah Azza wa Jal to reward upon it. So that's why you wanted to gain the pleasure of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Gain the pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jal by fasting the month of Ramadan for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. And as well be amongst those who remembers Allah Azza wa Jal and take advantage, my brothers and sisters, take advantage of every single second in the month of Ramadan to be amongst those who Allah Azza wa Jal will free them from the punishment of the hellfire. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to enable us to fast the month of Ramadan. And we ask Allah to enable us to fast many, many other Ramadans to come. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jal to accept our deeds in this month of Ramadan and all our deeds. And we ask Allah to be amongst those who are al-dhakirin Allah kathiran al-dhakirat, those who remember Allah a lot from the men and the women. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jal to accept our ibadat, our fasting, our qiyam al-layl. And we ask Allah to give us the courage and to enable us to do the maximum reward, to do the maximum righteous deeds in the month of Ramadan, and to gain the pleasure of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jal to unite us with our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Jannat al-Firdaus. عباد الله إن الله أمركم بأمر بذأبي بنفسه وثنى بملائكة القدس فقال جل من قائل إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. My brothers, just wanted to remind you something, because I was sending salutation upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and I didn't see my brothers sending their salutation upon him alayhi salatu wasalam. Listen to this hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was climbing the minbar. The first step he said Ameen. The second step he said Ameen. And the third step he said Ameen. And then the Sahaba of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they asked him, O Masih of Allah, we heard you saying Ameen three times. He said, Jibreel alayhi salam came to me and he told me, may a person lived in a time that his elderly, his father and mother, or one of them, reached an old age and he didn't enter Jannah. May this person to be humiliated and his nose to be in dust and to be away from the mercy of Allah Azza wa Jal. Who's making dua? Jibreel alayhi salam. And who's saying Ameen? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the second step he said, alayhi salatu salam, Jibreel is saying the dua. May a person that he witnessed the month of Ramadan And he did the, and if he didn't gain the forgiveness from Allah Azza wa Jal, may this person to be humiliated and his nose to be in dust and as well to be away from the mercy of Allah Azza wa Jal. The one who's making dua is Jibreel alayhi salam. And the one who's saying Ameen Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then he said, may a person that your name was remembered in front of him, and if he didn't send salutation upon you, may this person to be humiliated and his nose to be in dust and to be away from the mercy of Allah Azza wa Jal. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Ameen. So when we say our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam name, the minimum that we should do from us is to say alayhi salatu wa sallam, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And welcome to Salam al Rose.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Hayya 'ala as-salah, hayya 'ala al-falah. قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
لا إله إلا الله استقيم الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين قل يا أيها الكافرون لا أعبد ما تعبدون ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد ولا أنا عابد ما عبدتم ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد لكم دينكم ولي دين الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. Thank you.